हेलो, एम आई ऑडिबल स्टूडेंट्स?
यस मैम।
ओके, हाय ओनली 6 स्टूडेंट्स आर देयर। कैन यू सी माय स्क्रीन? नो। Yes, can you see the PPT?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Okay, so last lecture we discussed about e-marketplaces, e-catalogs. Just wait and give me 2 minutes. Okay, so in today's lecture, we are going to study the concept of social collaboration. Okay, what is collaboration? Then under collaboration, there is something called as social collaboration that we are going to study. The concept of collaboration 2.0, Internet of Things, L-commerce, F-commerce and e-tailing. Okay, so these are the concepts that we are going to study in today's lecture. Now, to begin with, can you tell me what do you mean by the word collaboration? Yes, anyone? What is collaboration? Fine. See, what is collaboration? A collaboration is basically coming together. Okay, in simple terms, we say that collaboration means individuals, okay, or companies, they come together and they carry out certain task or activity collectively. Okay, so that is why we say that the companies collaborate each other. Okay, they collaborate with each other and then carry out certain task. Okay, so collaboration is coming together to serve the interest of the organization or individual. That is the simple meaning of collaboration. Now here in case of e-commerce, what is the meaning of collaboration? It is one of the major applications of Web 2.0. Okay, it is the application of Web 2.0. Now Web 2.0, we know. What is Web 2.0? We have seen the concept of Web 2.0. Web 2.0 is nothing but, you know, this second generation tools and techniques. Okay, social media tools and techniques, internet, intranet, clouds, okay, cloud computing services. These are the tools that we use in Web 2.0. So collaboration is, e-collaboration is also one of the applications of Web 2.0 and social media in the enterprise in the area of collaboration. Okay. Now collaboration in business, it can be defined as the people working with other people towards the common outcome. Okay. So there is a common purpose or a common goal. Why the people work together? Because they have certain common interest or common objective. We call it as an outcome. So people, they work together and serve their common purposes or outcome. That is what we call it as an collaboration. Okay. Now, when we're talking about a collaboration, okay, social collaboration, basically it refers to people's collaboration within and between the communities, okay, enabled by social media tools and platforms. Okay, I'll read once again. Social collaboration is, it refers to people's collaboration within community. Like there is one community, so among that community people can collaborate with each other. Or if there are various communities, online communities are there. So online communities, when these communities interact and collaborate with each other by the social media tool or platforms, then that we call it as an social collaboration. Okay. The concept is, the main concept is collaboration, coming together and doing some activity or work. But whenever we say social collaboration, so there is a social angle to it, that, you know, the communities, they collaborate within themselves, or various communities are there, then they come together and then they use social media tools and platforms for collaborating. Okay, just give me a moment. Okay. Now, the processes that help people interact and share the information to achieve the common goal. So there are certain processes why the people are coming together, because they want to achieve common goal. Now, there is something called as collaboration 2.0. Okay. See, we have seen the concept. We have seen the concept Web 2.0. Okay. So Web 2.0. So like that, there is a term called collaboration 2.0. So what is collaboration 2.0? Collaboration 2.0 is recognized as major element of social business that can provide considerable benefits to the individual or to the organizations. Okay, that is what we call it as an collaboration 2.0. And why it is 2.0? Because it make use of Web 2.0 tools. That is why it is called as collaboration 2.0. Okay, simple. So collaboration, basically it drives the business value up by enabling people to work together more efficiently. Okay, collaboration basically helps people to work together. Group of people are there, they come together, they share their ideas, problems are brainstormed, and they collectively find out the solution to the problem. Okay, so that is how is the collaboration works. Wikis and other software tools can be used effectively by all types and sizes of enterprises for the wide range of tasks and activities. So there are different types of wikis, Wikipedia, Webopedia, and other social software tools are there, which can be used by different enterprises for coming together and carrying out certain tasks. Okay. Now, collaboration, it helps with solving the business problems and uncovering the new opportunities. Okay. And it is specially with the help of social media tools. Okay. Now, this is very important. Why people are using the collaboration tools more and more? Because it helps to solve the business problem. See, in the organization itself, we can solve the problem among the employees, okay, within the employees of the organization. But there are also different communities on the social media which work and which identifies the solution, which uncover the different opportunities, talk about the hurdles, okay, bring solution to the hurdles, solve the problem and give the solution. Okay, so this is possible with the help of social media tools, right? Now, collaboration in social networking is done both internally among the employees from the different units working in virtual teams, and it also happens externally when working with suppliers, customers, or other business partners. So that is within your supply chain. So collaboration, there are two types, internal collaboration and external collaboration. Okay. Or we also call it as an inter and intra. So intra is within the organization. Okay. The collaboration that happens among employees from different units working together in a virtual team. So say, you know, different units. For example, if we're talking about any IT project, okay, so in IT project, there is a developer team, there is a testing team, okay, then there are software engineers who takes the requirement, system analysts are there, okay. So when we talk about one project team, it consists of different units who work together in an integrated manner and then develop particular software. So this is an example of the collaboration, and they meet virtually and then they carry out certain task or carry out the solve the problem and work towards achieving the common objective. Okay. So this happens within the organization internally, within the employees from different units working together. Okay. And then another type is external collaboration. So external collaboration is what? The organization collaborating with other individuals in other organizations. Okay. One company collaborating with other company. Okay. So they can be suppliers, they can be your customers, they can be your distributors, they can be your suppliers, business partners, consultant, and so on. Okay. So that is what is the example of internal and external collaboration. Now just let us see the concept of social collaboration. Okay. Now just let me share with you the diagram from the book. Okay. Right. So when we are talking about a social collaboration, it is a multidimensional concept. Okay. Social collaboration, it has various, like you can see in the diagram, there are various dimensions of social collaboration. Okay. So what it consists of, okay, and what it can do, what is the scope of social collaboration, that you can see with the help of this diagram. So the first is wiki platform, collaboration portals, Twitter, use of mobile devices, public social networks, private social networks, partners discoveries, social customers, communication model, expert discovery, social software, crowdsourcing, social search and sharing. So these are all the different dimension, different activities that can be performed under social collaboration. See, Wiki's platform. We know there are Wikipedia, Webopedia platforms are there where people can edit the content. So all the, you know, any person, if you go and visit the Wikipedia, you can also change the contents in the Wikipedia. So it is an open platform which is shared by all the individuals, okay, and it can be edited, okay. So it is free for all. Collaboration portals are there. See, collaboration portals, or we call it as an collaboration platforms, okay. Now what are the examples of collaboration portal or collaboration platform? See, the very common example is Google Drive. Now Google Drive is a very common example. If you look at the Google common drive, the Google Drive, let me just show you. See, on your Gmail, okay, you can see different types of applications. Okay, there are these 9 dots. So whenever you open your Google, you can see all these facilities, okay. For example, there is a search, there is a maps, YouTube, Play, News, Gmail, Meet, Contacts, Drive, Calendar, Translator, Shopping, Slides, and so many. Classroom. So Google Classroom is also the example of collaboration. Like, I can open Google Classroom for digital business subject, where I can post all my assignments, all my notes, and I can share the link with you all. So you can use this classroom platform. Okay, so this is a collaboration between the institute, like me. Okay, I am the representative of the institute and the students. Okay, so this is an example of free collaboration tool for learning. So we have a common purpose, that is learning. Okay, this is an easy example. Then also Drive. Okay, so Google Drive is also one example where you can share the services. Whatever you save on your Google Drive, you you can share the links. Okay, links. For example, you can save some videos, some audio files, some notes, some ebooks on your drive, and you can share that drive to the collaborators, like the individuals or with whom you are partnering. Okay, so Google Drive is also there. See, last year I opened the Google Classroom that I will show you. Okay, so in a classroom I have opened MBA 1 classroom and MBA 2 classroom, and there I shared ebooks, okay, some online quizzes also I have shared, digital business online exam also I have conducted for your senior batch, computer proficiency and knowledge test also I have shared online. Okay, so like this, on the Google Drive you can share different documents, and that is the example of your collaboration. Okay, so that is what we were talking about, collaboration portals or collaboration platforms. Then Twitter is also a very common example, a social collaboration platform where people come together, join the community, form the online communities for sharing the information. Okay, again, the use of mobile devices is one of the driving force for the social collaboration. The smartphones we are using, yes, nowadays everything, whatever we are doing, is with the help of smartphone. We are, you know, communicating, we are filling the exam forms, we are filling the eligibility forms, scholarship forms. Okay, all the instructions are straight away given to you through WhatsApp, email. So this is possible just because of the smartphones or the technology. Right, then public social networks. So public social networks are, your Facebook is a public social network, WhatsApp is a public social network, right? LinkedIn is your public professional network. Okay,
So there are certain public social network and also private social networks which can be formed within the organization, like the groups within the organization can be formed to solve the problems of within the organization. Okay, and whenever we talk about a public social network, that the problem is discussed openly in the community, and then it is solution to that problem is derived, right? So public social network, private social networks are the part of social collaboration. Okay, partner discovery means social your supply chain. Okay, supply chain partners, suppliers, okay, then customers, distributors, retailers, all these we call it as an partners. Okay, so you can identify with the help of this social collaboration, you meet many people. Okay, you come to know about the people who have interest in your business, who are willing to work with you. Okay, so there are social communities which help in, you know, discovering the social or discovering the supply chain partners. Then we also talked about the social customer. Okay, so it is also one of the driving force for social collaboration. Communication models. Okay, we talked about different models. Okay, when we talk about a communication, there is a synchronous, asynchronous communication model. Okay, remote communication is there. So even if we don't have a physical, you know, connectivity, we can still be connected using the Wi-Fi channel. Okay, so Wi-Fi network of communication is also there. So this all are nothing but the part of social collaboration. It facilitates the growth of social collaboration. Expert discovery, different experts, consultants, teachers, scholars, you can locate online, and then it can be used to grow your business. Then different social softwares. Okay, social search is possible, and sharing of information is also possible. Okay, now last lecture we also talked about something called as crowdsourcing. Now crowdsourcing is also one of the important dimensions of social collaboration. What is crowdsourcing? Can anybody tell me what is crowdsourcing? Last time we have discussed. Last lecture we talked about crowdsourcing. What is it? Okay, see, let me tell you what is crowdsourcing is. It is one of the platform. Okay, I'll repeat this point once again. Listen carefully. What is crowdsourcing? Crowdsourcing is nothing but a platform for e-commerce. Okay, one of the platform for e-commerce, and it is a platform for collective intelligence in e-commerce and social commerce. People come together. Okay, they share the problem, they suggest the people in the group, they suggest different alternatives, and group itself, okay, come out with a single or concrete solution. So crowd is there, you know, crowd is there, the group of people, that is what we call it as a crowd. So crowd is there to handle, define, you know, interpret the information, analyze the problem, and bring out the solution. That is what we call it as an crowd sourcing in simple term. Okay, crowd, it refers to any group of people, such as group of consumers, it can be group of employees, the crowd can be group of corporations, members of certain social network. Suppose if we have any social network, for example Bhumi, you know, do you know about Bhumi? Bhumi is it is a NGO. Okay, it carry out lot many social activities, educating the illiterate people, you know, making green products. It carry out online campaigns, okay, spreading the social beneficial messages. So there is a Bhumi, which is a NGO, okay. So it can be a members of such social network who work together. There can be a group of group of members of social network who offer expertise, okay. So that is what is the crowd in general. We call it as an large group of people, okay. Now let me just show you the diagram. I don't know if it is there. Just wait. Crowdsourcing 84. Okay. So this diagram, it shows the elements of crowdsourcing. What are the elements of crowdsourcing, right? So the triangle, it represents, you know, three aspects, three elements. First is the psychology or sociology of the crowd. What is the inclination of the crowd? The crowd has, the aim which is social in nature. The crowd has the aim which is a profit in nature. The crowd has the some common goal which is inclined towards, personal interest or like that. So it talks basically about the psychology of the crowd, identifying the tendency of what is the, thinking of the crowd. Then there are these technology or web 2.0 tools used by the crowd. And then the crowd, it uses different models, e-business models we have talked about, right? B2B, B2C, C2C. So different models are used by the crowd for the implementation. So when it comes to implementation, there is a crowd and there is process models. Okay. When it comes to technology, different tasks are performed with the help of process models. And when it comes to psychology or sociology of the crowd needs to carry out different tasks with a certain psychology in mind. Okay. So when we are talking about, the process of crowdsourcing, okay, here it is given what is the process of the crowdsourcing, right? So it is nothing but a collective problem solving or work sharing process, and usually it is conducted as web-based activity. Okay, so problems are broadcasted on the group. Like if there is an open group, the problems are shared openly on the, it is broadcasted openly on the crowd or on the group, or it can be shared to unknown group of participants as well. Okay. Now, once the problem is shared, the communication starts within the group. Okay. Every individual in the group shares the opinion, gives the information, give the valuable inputs. Okay. So the members of the crowd are organized as online communities, and members submit the individual solutions, what they feel like. Okay. So they may suggest the solution, and crowd may also discuss the solution and vote for the final solution. So let's say, suppose there are 10 solutions which are suggested. So from these 10 solutions, one solution can be shortlisted. So like that, the crowdsourcing, it is beneficial for bringing out the best solution among the alternatives which are available. Got it? So these are nothing but different dimensions of social collaboration in e-commerce. Yes, so social collaboration, it is a multi-dimensional concept, right? Then coming to the next topic, there is something, the concept called as Internet of Things, that is IoT. Okay. Now, can anybody tell me what is IoT? Internet of Things. Yes. Can you give me the example of IoT? Yes. IoT, Internet of Things. And let us say you go to Google and type Internet of Things concept. So you will come across, see, whenever you want to search, you know, anything in with related to digital business, whatever the terms we have seen till now, okay, you can Google that term, put in the search box, okay, say Internet of Things, that is IoT, it stands for IoT, and say give enter. So it will give you what is the meaning of IoT, okay. Okay, so Internet of Things. So see, whenever we talking about Internet of Things, see, in simple terms I'll tell you, the example of Internet of Things is that we are controlling the lights of our house remotely. We are switching on and off the geyser situated in our bathroom remotely. Okay. Then RFID tags, whenever we visit any mall, okay, there are tags which are situated on the clothes, new clothes that you buy. So you cannot take out the cloth outside the mall, and if any person tries to do so, there will be the alarm, okay. So alarm will be there and it will start sounding it, right. So this is what, this is the example of your IoT, Internet of Things. So what is it? If we look at the definition, the Internet of Things is the system of interrelated computing devices. It can be mechanical and digital machines, objects, animals, or people that are provided with unique identifiers. Okay, the tags, different tags that can be attached, okay, to your clothes, for example, okay. So a person can be located depending on the tags that are located on your cloth. This is also one of the example, okay. So Internet of Things, it is nothing but the system of interrelated computing devices, okay, mechanical or digital machines, objects, okay, unique identifiers, and the ability to transfer data over network without requiring human to human or human to computer interaction. So everything is carried out automatically, okay. There are sensors which are attached to the device, okay, and then these sensors automatically execute the program and then execute the task. So let's see, there are certain examples. A thing in Internet of Things can be person with heart monitoring implant, a farm animal with biochip, that is transponder, then an automobile that uses inbuilt sensor to alert the driver when the pressure of the tire is low or high, okay. So locational sensors are also there, like whenever we are reversing our automobile, four wheeler, so it will, there are sensors that are attached to the back end of the car. So that is the example of IoT, Internet of Things. It senses the signal and according to the signal it executes the information and then it gives away the message, okay. So that is nothing but IoT concept, right. So how it works, an IoT consists of web enabled smart devices that use embedded system. Now what is embedded system? Embedded system is nothing but the software, okay. We use their, you know, when we talk about IT, there are two things. One is software and another is hardware. Okay. Now, what is embedded system? Embedded system is combination of this hardware and software.
Okay, so software which is embedded in the form of program in the hardware, it give rise to embedded system. So these embedded systems, it consist, it consists of processors, it consists of different sensors, it consists of communication hardware, okay, transmitter, receiver. Communication hardware is what? Transmitter and receiver to collect and send and act on data they require from the environment. So it consists of different smart devices, sensors and hardware which work together, okay, in IoT. So IoT devices, they share the sensor data they collect by connecting to an IoT gateway or other edge devices, where data is either sent to the cloud to be analyzed or analyzed locally. So cloud, many a times IoT, it consists of, make use of cloud services, because everything happens remotely. So IoT is very much based on cloud computing, right? So that is the concept of IoT, right? See, here is the diagram or example of IoT. So input, process and output, okay? So in input, we have IoT device. Okay, so input is there, then process and orange color blocks, they show the output. So what happens at the input? At the input, we have IoT device, that is the sensor. So sensor is the input device. It senses the signal, okay? It may sense the location, it may sense the hurdle, it may sense the level of the water, okay? So anything, there are different types of sensor. Those who are engineers, they may know this concept of sensor, okay? So IoT devices, it is nothing but a sensor or any antenna, okay, wireless antenna, which is situated as a part of communication channel, okay, or any IoT device, that is microcontroller or microprocessor chips are there. So all these, devices, digital devices are there, which collects the data, okay, and this data is collected and then it is transferred to IoT hub, or there is something called as IoT gateway. Hub is what? Hub is a switch. Okay. You know, we have learned whenever we talk about different topologies, like a star topology is there, where, there is a central server and then there are 10 computers which are connected to the server. Okay. So that represents the star topology. So in star topology, what happens? At the center, there is a hub or there is a switch which controls everything. So in IoT also, there is an IoT hub, okay, whose task is to take the input, okay, take the input from IoT device like sensor, antenna, microcontroller or microprocessor chips, process it, and then it gives out the, it analyzes the data and take the required action. Okay, so what can be the action? The action can be user interface, that is some command is given to the user through smartphone or human machine. Okay, there are washing machines, for example. So at the outcome, we have the smart devices which gives us the which gives us the instructions, like washing machines are there, security, door security services are there, right? So user interface devices, then analytics of business applications like customer relationship management, certain ERP softwares are there to whom this input is provided, and then there are also backend systems. Okay, so backend systems are nothing but the systems which works at the backend, handle the database, okay, gives away the instruction as per the user's requirement to the front end, right? So that is how there is a, you know, concept of IoT, that first it collects the data, in second stage it collects and transfer the data, and in third stage it analyze the data and take the required action. Okay, so that is the working system of how an IoT system works, from collecting the data and taking the action. Okay, now why it is important? Because nowadays, you know, the people have become very busy. It is not possible to carry out, you know, each and every work by a person individually. So individual is also looking for some smart gadgets who can work on their behalf. Hai na? We are in so hurry. Tam aplyala asa vatta, for example, ki apan gharatun bahir padlo, are fan band karayacha rahila kiwa light band karayachi rahili, tam konitari asa paije ki automatically te light kiwa fan band zala paije, kiwa apan washing machine laun gelo tar automatically tyajatle कपडे वाळून किंवा धुऊन वाळून गेले पाहिजेत. ओके, किंवा डोअरवर सिक्युरिटी आहे तर कोणी आपलं डोअर उघडलं आपण नसताना, आपण कुठेतरी हॉलिडेला गेलो आहे आणि इफ अ स्ट्रेंजर कम्स इन आवर हाऊस देन वी शूड गेट ऑल द इन्फॉर्मेशन. किंवा आपण इथे आहोत दुसऱ्या लोकेशनला, पण घरी आपल्याकडे काय चाललं आहे, घरी सिक्युरिटी किंवा CCTV चा ॲक्सेस तुम्हाला तिथे राहून, बाहेर राहून तुम्हाला रिमोट लोकेशनला भेटला पाहिजे. ओके, सो दिस इज व्हॉट, दिस इज दॅट द ह्युमन कॅनॉट बी प्रेझेंट ॲट ईच अँड एव्हरी लोकेशन टू परफॉर्म ऑल दीज ॲक्टिव्हिटीज. सो देअर इज धिस रिक्वायरमेंट ऑफ स्मार्ट डिव्हायसेस ऑर इंटरनेट ऑफ थिंग्स. ओके, IoT. व्हाय इट इज कॉल्ड ॲज IoT? बिकॉज इट इज ऑल बेस्ड ऑन द इंटरनेट. It make use of the cloud computing technology for carrying out all these tasks remotely. Okay, got it? The concept of IoT devices, your wristwatch is also the example of IoT device. Okay, so that is the concept of IoT, right? So it involves connecting electronic devices, including embedded microprocessor, to communicate information, right? And the analyst, they predict that by the year 2020 or maybe 21, there will be more than 50 billion devices which will be connected to the internet. Whatever the devices, they are connected to internet, become the part of IoT. Our mobile phone is also IoT device because it is connected to the internet and it is useful in carrying out many multiple tasks. So whatever the device we connect to the internet, that is nothing but your IoT device. Okay, got it the concept? And it basically works on the concept of machine to machine communication, one machine interacting with other machine for performing the task. Okay, so M2M technology is used in IoT. So what is M2M technology? Might be the set of devices that monitor traffic in the city and communicate the information to city's traffic lights in order to regulate the flow of traffic. Now this is one example of IoT. Okay, so traffic lights, these are connected to the internet. Okay, and because of this, even the person or police officer sitting in the control room can see what is happening on the streets. So this is the example of IoT. Got it? Right. So these concepts, I think we have already discussed. What is L-commerce? Yes, L-commerce, it stands for locational commerce, hai na? The services which are offered with the use of location, for example Google Maps, or you know, food delivery apps, or let's say Ola and Uber,
Yes, all these are locational based services, right? Then F commerce also we have discussed. F commerce stands for Facebook commerce. Okay, so it is a strategy that focuses on developing or designing e-commerce content and storefront sites within Facebook social networking sites. So Facebook itself, Facebook platform itself is used for carrying out the e-commerce trade. That is why it is called as F commerce. F commerce can take the form of shopping tabs. So different shopping, small scale business owners, individuals are there who can make use of Facebook for shopping. Okay. Many bakery shops are there online. Okay. Bakery shops, grocery shops are also there. Embroidery shops, some services, beauty products. So many small scale industries are there who are using F commerce for carrying out their business, right? Fine. So that's it. We will stop today, right? So in today's lecture, what we have seen is the concept of social collaboration we have seen. Okay. Then the concept of Internet of Things, right? L commerce and F commerce, that is Facebook commerce, right? Any doubt in this? Yes, are you listening? Yes, any doubt?
No, ma'am.
Okay. So, fine. Today's lecture is over. Fine. So, you can now leave this meet.